Hi guys, Mike here, Wongo ShortPlay. Today we're playing Chase HQ2 for the Sega Mega Drive. Now, if I remember correctly, this is not what we expect, or what I was expecting at least. Let's just get into it and find out. Alright, we've got a few. What's that? Let's go with the sports car. We know where we stand with the sports car. Actually, this does look quite similar to what I was expecting. I'm sure there's a version of Chase HQ2 that isn't like this at all. Oh, actually, this is a bit rough, if I'm perfectly honest. But we'll stick with it, we'll stick with it. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, is there a version of Chase HQ2 that has a different, like an in-car camera view? Because I remember playing that or something like that, and it was awesome. Unfortunately, this Chase HQ2 seems to be just like THQ, but really, really jagged to play. Jerky, as you can probably see. Single frame 10 animations. And like literally, there's no like inertia to any of the movements. It's just you go that way at that speed, unless you're going around the corner. God, it is. Oh no, we've got those horrible bridges that just go on and on, and you can fall off the edges way too easy. We don't like those. Ow, get out of my way. Ow. Right. To be fair though, it's not really, really difficult, which is kind of nice. But this isn't... Oh, I need nitros. I'm sure there's another HQ2 though, on the Mega Drive. I know there's another one where you've got a gun, and this is the thing that I don't like about this. The gun was... I wouldn't say it's a necessarily necessary addition to Chase HQ. The original Chase HQ was amazing, especially the Spectrum version, funnily enough, which is the one I played as a kid. And I was so shocked when I played the Amiga version, and it just wasn't as good, because I was expecting, you know, better. In fact, I'd argue that the arcade version is only just better than the Spectrum version to play. But, hey, got him. Loads of time. But, see, it feels like this is like one of those Mega Drive alternative sequels, which is it's kind of a straight. Let's get that one. It's kind of a straight sequel to Chase HQ 1, isn't it? Same game, or the difference being you've got a selection of vehicles to use now. Terrible animations, though. Terrible lack of animation. I wonder if this was like slower and more powerful. Do you need slower and more powerful? The car essentially lasts until it smashes the enemy car up, doesn't it? Doesn't need to be powerful. Oh no, it's one of those big bridges. Certain death at every side. Break. Oh, come on. Yeah, that was horrible. Oh, like the little wave effects crashing on the side of it. But really, who makes roads like this? Some kind of boundaries, please. Anyway. I do miss the gun. I saw Chase HQ2, and the first thing you think, well, I think, is, oh yeah, that's the Chase HQ where you get to shoot out the top of your car. He's gone that way. Yes. Which was a cool touch, and it was dead simple. The implementation of it was good, and you get the bazooka, and later on you get to, you know, really kick some bum with it. It's the red one, isn't it? It's my old car he's nicked. That's cheap. That's cheap on the graphics if it is my old car. Considering they've all got one frame of animation for turning. But I should be able to shoot now, just hammer off bullets at him. Because it's Chase HQ 2. Whoa, that was silly. Unnecessary ramp that made me go sideways. Was that him? Oh no, that's him. I got confused between that other identical criminal car, non-criminal car. Like GTA, with a limited amount of car types. Uh oh, I think we're in trouble now because we've got no turbo. And this car is slower. Oh no, I've got a damage bar, haven't I? Oh, I don't know. No, that's a damage bar, the red one. Come on. In fact, there's no reason not to use a sports car if speed is the only, is the only facet here. Yeah, speed is the only facet here. It's just HQ, but a bit poo. Nancy, it's Nancy at GCHQ. Okay, let's have this one. The three different vehicles don't really work because you only need the sports car. Why the heck would they be driving one of these? I mean, I imagine they can take anything out with this, but I'm guessing Or maybe, oh, this just runs over at obstacles by the looks of it. Oh, except for trucks, which is the only thing I've managed to actually hit. Oh, come on, really? Every truck on the road I've managed to hit. Except that one. Oh, I'm stuck. It's not very fun. I mean, it's alright. It's not as fun as Chase HQ. They've done an alright job. It's a competent Chase HQ game. It's not SCI. It's not the same game as SCI. Chase HQ 2 Special Criminal Investigation, which, let's face it, all the console, all the computer versions of it, all the ports of it were rubbish anyway. And terrible frame rates and just weren't very fun to play. This is more fun than any port of Chase HQ 2. So that's the arcade. So that's fair enough. That's weird how that happened. That's me using my turbo, by the way, on a truck. Look at that. Oh, what? I ran out of time. Yeah, go on, let's go. I know I'm sounding really disappointed right now, and I am, because this is my last video of the day, and I was hoping to play a totally different game. I'm sure. Oh, look, he's got a gun, and I haven't. That's even more of an insult to the fact that I haven't got a gun. What's got me really annoyed is that I know I played another Chase HQ. Maybe it was a SNES version I'm thinking of. A 16-bit version, regardless, of Chase HQ 2, in which you had a gun, and the camera view was in the car, and it wasn't terrible. In fact, on the contrary, it was blinking brilliant. It was really good. It might be the best Chase HQ game I've played. It was great, I think, anyway. Alright, maybe the original Chase HQ was better because it was the original idea. But other than that, it was awesome. This game I played was awesome. Now, what version am I talking about, boys and girls? Does anyone know what I'm on about? Has anyone else played a version of Chase HQ? I think it's Chase HQ 2 that is in the cockpit of the car, in the driving seat of the car, where you're in, you know, the driver's point of view. And it's, you know, uses scaling and whatnot. It's a 16-bit game. It's not a 3D game by any means, but it's really, really slick and really well done and really good fun. And I don't think there's any of this massive bridge over nothing nonsense. Does anyone know what I'm on about? Am I talking about a SNES game? I wasn't a big SNES kid, you see, but I think I played this emulated, and I assume from memory it was the Mega Drive version, but it's not this. Definitely not this. This is not as good as the game I played, and I'm a kid through and through. But if it's the SNES version, I'll take my hat off to it. I'm happy to discover good SNES games, because I've got a SNES here, and I'm dying to play, you know, good SNES games on it. I don't know what games to buy for that, actually. That's a good point. Maybe this is a good forum to ask, eh? I've got a SNES. I've got very few games for it. I don't really know what's good. I suppose I should do a, playlist on this channel and find them. But those of you who know SNES games, what are the best SNES games? What's the point? What would I like? I love my brawlers. I loved Batman Returns for the SNES. Although it's a little bit boring after a couple of hours, you know, gets a bit samey. And it isn't as good as Streets of Rage as Brawlers go. But it was great. What would I like on the SNES? And is Chase HQ 2 on the SNES that brilliant one I'm thinking of? They're my questions for you today. Answers on postcards. Don't send answers on a postcard. That's a stupid idea. No one does that now. Just leave me a message. Oh, you're going down. No, I'm not going. I am going down. Yeah, this truck's rubbish. Oh, this level's hard. It's one of the two. I can't decide. I'm rubbish, I think, is the real problem here. And I hate these blooming roads. Look at this. Oh, forget it. Chase HQ 2 on the Sega Mega Drive. Not terrible, but a bit of a disappointment considering what I was hoping for. Anyway, thanks for watching.